They're not from here. They're not supposed to be here. And I think it's very important to control something that could be so destructive.
One adult sea lamprey will kill an average of 40 pounds of fish in its lifetime.
The Upper Great Lakes, they were invaded in the 1930s, 40s, and 50s, and they came in through the shipping canals that bypassed Niagara Falls.
I'm researching with Nick Johnson on sea lamprey pheromone research.
Going to state for 6 years, getting my master's and PhD, it's great that you can take something that's been developed at Michigan State and apply it to a major problem like sea lampreys in the Great Lakes. Basically, on a given day, we go to the river.
Okay, 1.75. Mm-hmm.
And we measure how much water is moving through the river.
0.70 meters per second.
Then my assistant, Nicole, will go and prepare the vials of pheromone for each given night for the next 3 or 4 days.
And it's plugged into a data sheet to determine how much pheromone we need to pump for one evening. We'll pump anywhere from approximately 1 milliliter all the way up to around 10 milliliters.
The first thing that I'm going to enter is how much water is moving through the river.
And then we'll set up a simple pumping system that will pump the pheromone into the trap.
It doesn't take very much pheromone for the lamprey to be able to detect it. If you're interested in fishing for any of those larger fish species, then you should be at least educated about the effects of sea lamprey.
So right now in Michigan, we're pumping the pheromone 3-kPZS into 10 streams. That's an abbreviation for 3-ketopetromyzanol sulfate. Some people have called it a love potion, but I mainly call it 3-kPZS because we kill them. It's not a love potion, it's a death potion.
It attaches onto, a fish, the suction cup mouth, and then there it will suck the bodily fluids out of the fish and kill it.
When the lamprey are out in the lakes, they are parasitizing fish like lake trout.
We're trapping thousands and thousands of lamprey out of these rivers. I mean, if you just do the math, that's a lot of dead fish.
We actually monitor our application to the stream by taking water samples. And those water samples then we ship back to Michigan State. And in the lab of Wei Ming, we analyze those and we're able to detect the pheromone we add to the stream using some pretty cool chemistry techniques down there.
Our lab has been devoted to finding a new method to control the sea lamprey. That is to use pheromones that we believe are highly potent and highly specific.
The research in Wei Ming's lab started the development of identifying the pheromone, synthesizing it, and characterizing it, and now we're going to hopefully see it being used to control lampreys in one of the coolest, I think, lake systems in the world, where you have a very diverse fishery. When you look at how many fish a lamprey kills and how many fish humans kill, in Lake Superior, lampreys still kill twice as many fish as humans. The idea was to diversify the control technique and also to explore environmentally benign and cheap alternatives. In our design, we have 2 traps at each stream, and 1 trap is baited and the other isn't. And looking at the preliminary results, it looks like the baited trap that has pheromone is catching about 50% more than the trap that's not baited, which could be a major help to the control program.
The data that we've seen so far, it looks like we're definitely making an impact on the amount of lamprey that we're catching. I think this project's really important because it has a lot of potential. We're early in, but this could be something that really helps control sea lamprey in the Great Lakes.